Translation. Of course it is bewildering, O soul of the universe, that you work, though you are inactive, that you take birth, though you are the vital force and the unborn. You yourself descend amongst animals, men, sages, and aquatics. Verily, this is bewildering.
So, Krishna is addressed here at Vishyatman, the vital force of the universe. Just like in my body, in your body, that there is a vital force. The vital force is the Atma, the living being, living entity or soul. So because the vital force, the soul is there, the whole body is working. So similarly, there is the supreme vital force. Supreme vital force is Krishna, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, where is the question of his taking birth, appearance or disappearance? In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, janma karmam cha me dibbam. Dibbam means this is spiritual. Ajopi san abhyatma. Ajo means unborn. Abhyatma, without any distraction. So Krishna is existing as in the beginning of this stotra, Kunti addressed Krishna that you are within, you are without. It's still invisible. Krishna is within, without. That we have explained. Ishara sarva-bhutanam riddhesha-arjuna-tishthati sarvasya-chaham riddhesha-nivishtya. Krishna is situated in everyone's heart, therefore he is within everything. Andantarastham paramanuchayantarastham, he is within the atom, even, and without also. Vishwarup, as Krishna showed, the Vishwarup, external feature, this gigantic cosmic manifestation, that is Krishna's external body, these are described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The hills, the mountains, they are described as the bones. Just like we have got in our body some part raised by the bones. Similarly, these big mountains and hills, they have been described as the bones. And these big oceans, they have been described as different holes in the body, down and up. Similarly, the Brahmaloka is the skull, upper skull. So, one who cannot see God, they have been advised to see God in so many ways. These are the instructions in the Vedic literature. Because you can simply conceive of God, the great. The greatness, you also do not know how great He is. So, in your conception of greatness, just like the very high mountains, the sky, the big, big planet. So the description is there. You can think of, that is also Krishna consciousness. If you think that this mountain is the bone of Krishna, that is also Krishna. Actually, that is so. If you think that this big Pacific Ocean is the navel of Krishna, these big, big trees, plants, they are here in the body of Krishna. And then the head, the skull of Krishna is the Brahma Loka. The soul is the Patal Loka. Similarly, this is Mahato Mahiyan. When you think of Krishna as the greater than the greatest, you can think like this. And if you think the Krishna is both smaller than the smallest, that is also greatness. That is also greatness. Krishna can manufacture this gigantic cosmic manifestation, and he can manufacture also a small insect smaller than the point. You have seen sometimes in the book, you'll find one insect is running. The shape is smaller than the full star. This is Krishna's craftsmanship. Anurani yanga mahato mahiyan. He can create bigger than the biggest and the smaller than the smallest. Now human being, according to their conception, they have manufactured the 747 airplane, supposed to be very big. All right, according to your consciousness, you have produced something big, but can you produce a small aeroplane like insect flying? That is not possible. Therefore, greatness means that who can become greater than the greatest and smaller than the smallest. That is greatness.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,